This video was made possible by Wix. If you're ready to create a website, head over to wix.com/go/infographics to try out one of their premium plans right now. We've covered strange diseases before, such as Stoneman Syndrome, and our episode on strange neurological diseases. The world is full of unusual maladies that for sufferers can be devastating, but for the rest of us can be fascinating. Have you ever heard of foreign accent syndrome? One day, you suddenly sound like a French, Chinese, or Russian person, but have never been to those countries. You should watch the YouTube videos. What about Alice in Wonderland syndrome that can make people see objects much smaller than they actually are? Perhaps not a good ailment for insecure men. But we shouldn't joke. Such diseases can be terrifying and debilitating. While some unusual diseases render people in states that make life absolutely impossible, we'll talk about one such disease today in this episode of the Infographics Show, Encephalitis Lethargica, the sleeping sickness. Let's start with the definition of this disease, which is often abbreviated to EL. The National Institute of Neurological Disorders and Stroke tells us there is no clear cause for EL. As experts say, it remains a bit of a mystery. It might start as a headache, blurred vision, fever, slow movement, slow thinking, and in some cases a complete breakdown occurs that makes people into something of a statue. NIH also writes patients may also experience abnormal eye movements, upper body weakness, muscular pains, tremors, neck rigidity, and behavioral changes including psychosis. We know it's a form of encephalitis, which is an inflammation of the brain that could have been brought on by several viruses or autoimmune diseases. A bite from a tick could cause this terrible disease known as tick-borne encephalitis. A mosquito might also transmit this disease. Some kids after getting vaccines have also contracted the disease, but we're told cases are very rare. Britain's NHS further explains, encephalitis due to a reaction of a previous infection is known as post-infectious encephalitis. If it's caused by a tumor or the cause is unknown, it's called autoimmune encephalitis. Back to sleeping sickness, a kind of encephalitis that has no known cause and plenty of terrible symptoms. It was a disease that shocked the world during an outbreak between 1915 and 1926. It's said 5 million people around the world were infected during the epidemic, and more than a third of those people died. Many of those who did survive did not make a full recovery, meaning they were somewhat slowed down to say the least. The famous British neurologist Oliver Sacks, whom we have talked about before, said some patients would just sit there, motionless, staring but not interested in anything. They were like living statues. They neither conveyed nor felt the feeling of life. They were as insubstantial as ghosts, as passive as zombies, wrote Sacks. The website The Conversation writes about what it calls a curious case of encephalitis lethargica, saying that some of those affected seemed frozen in time. It writes about the stages of the disease. First, people would feel uneasy, have a mild fever, and perhaps develop double vision. Something was wrong, but they were not sure what. In the further stages, things got worse. Patients might lose all interest in life. They would become a different person altogether. Some of them became paralyzed and statue-like, and many people died at this point because of respiratory failure. But for those that survived, days or even years later, they might develop post-encephalitic Parkinsonism. We'll get around to that. But first, we should say that some people did get better. The Encephalitic Society writes, "Outcome is variable. Some people may make a full recovery, some patients die, and for others, a Parkinsonian-type state may persist." In all, around 40% of sufferers died, 20% survived but were severely handicapped, 26% recovered but were left with long-term issues, and 14% made full recoveries. So how were the people who lasted years before post-encephalitic Parkinsonism hit them? Most of them that lived for years before the final stage set in were mostly children. Some of those would grow up unusual to say the least, often exhibiting impulsive behavior or not taking interest in others. As they got older, some would almost become psychopathic. Errant behaviors included cruelty to anyone who crossed them, destructiveness, lying, and self-mutilation, including, in one example, removal of the eyes, writes The Conversation about some of the worst cases, adding, when they reached adolescence, those patients manifested inappropriate and excessive sexuality, including sexual assault without regard for age or gender. Some of these kids would improve after time, but for others, the only thing that would slow down their crazy behavior was the onset of post-encephalitic Parkinsonism. This would often happen when the adolescents became adults. Most of these people became confined to hospitals. Some patients described their state while in institutions as being not able to execute their will to do anything. Others were reduced to the state of looking much like the aforementioned statue. They were catatonic, but their minds were still working. You may have seen this dramatized in the movie Awakenings, in which survivors of EL are awoken from this catatonic state with the use of a drug, L-DOPA, which was administered by the famous Oliver Sacks. He wrote a book about it, and that's what the movie starring Robert De Niro was based on. Could an outbreak ever happen again? It seems there have been isolated cases. Virologist Professor John Oxford told the BBC in 2004 that he thought it could keep happening. Until we know what caused it, we won't be able to prevent it happening again, he said. The BBC writes about a girl in 1993 that was taken to a hospital hallucinating, shaking, and making strange clawing movements with her hands. Her brain was inflamed, and it turned out that the 23-year-old was suffering from, you guessed it, encephalitis lethargica. The girl did eventually get better, but it took 2 years. That wasn't the end, though, and the BBC writes that there were 20 more cases of this mysterious disease in the years to come, with some patients not fully recovering. On studying the cases, doctors found that one thing linked most of them. They had started feeling ill with a sore throat. These patients had been hit by a rare bacteria called Streptococcus bacteria. Doctors believed this had mutated and become EL. Had that been the case in the past? British doctors then went to look at medical records of those that were struck with EL in the past, and they found sore throats were always in the list of symptoms. They found that records noted that Diplococcus bacteria was found, which is a form of Streptococcus bacteria. Does that mean they solved the curious case and where it begins? Well, medical professionals still write that there has never been any definitive proof of what causes EL. Many experts do agree, however, that Streptococcus bacteria is a more compelling case than influenza, which many experts had first thought caused EL. Next time you get a sore throat, try not to lose your mind, though, as there's way more chance of you winning the lottery than coming down with EL. We should not finish this show without mentioning Austrian psychiatrist, neurologist, and Tom Selleck lookalike Constantine von Economo, who first documented this strange disease. He wrote the paper Die Encephalitis Lethargica, and that's where the name came from. He once wrote of the disease, to look at these patients, one would suppose them to be in a state of profound secondary dementia. Emotions are scarcely noticeable in the face, but they are mentally intact. That's a pretty sad way to end this video, so let's talk about something more fun for a second. When is the last time you've updated your website? Surely you know that at some point your current or future employers will most likely look at your website. If you want to make sure you're representing yourself in the best light, we suggest using Wix. Wix is a super easy yet professional and robust platform for creating, managing, and hosting your website. You can use a custom domain for anything from a blog to a website for a restaurant. Wix does all the heavy lifting. You can finally create that amazing website that you've been too afraid of making because you just didn't know how by going to wix.com/go/infographics or by clicking the link in the description. Don't wait until it's too late. Get a head start today with the amazing website you deserve. Can you imagine being trapped in that state? What do you think about this disease? Let us know in the comments. Also, be sure to check out our other video called What is Stoneman Syndrome? Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.